Another very exciting, very loaded GU19, ASCO GU2019. In kidney cancer specifically, a lot of new data presented, you know, in the oral session, in the rapid fire session, in the poster sessions, specifically the combinations are coming to renal cell cancer, and two studies that met the primary endpoint, axitinib and pembrolizumab, that has a progression-free survival response rate and an overall survival benefit against standard sunitinib in first-line advanced clear cell RCC. Similarly, axitinib and the PD-L1 inhibitor avelumab had a response rate and PFS benefit with a pending, you know, data analysis for overall survival against sunitinib. We have data also in non-clear cell RCC, a MET inhibitor, savolitinib plus a PD-L1 inhibitor in non-clear cell RCC presented by Dr. Powles, as well as a combination of atezolizumab and bevacizumab with Dr. McKay, showing a response rate up to 30% or a bit higher. That combination, we know its activity in clear cell RCC. Dr. McDermott also presented data again in non-clear cell RCC in pembrolizumab single agent, response rate around 25%, and invite you to look at the details to see what type of non-clear cell RCC may respond. As you know, non-clear cell RCC encompasses many sub-histologies, if you want. Also data from Dr. Rini, another new TKI we're familiar with from previous trial, tivozanib, now in third line, tivozanib versus sorafenib. The study met its primary endpoint. There had been a press release around it, and Dr. Rini presented that data. In the poster session and other session, there's a lot actually of correlatives and a lot of biomarker data that was presented that is interesting. Again, it's a very, very loaded GU19. It's hard now not to go to each of these meetings, you know, the ASCO meeting, the ASCO GU meeting, new information every time, and hopefully you're able to digest that information, perhaps on your trip back to where you come from. Thank you.